replays the tape.
We're now approaching the T-minus 1 minute mark. T-minus 1 minute. T-minus 1 minute. And counting. Now in the final minute of our countdown. At the 30-second mark, swing arm number one will retract.
You think I'll get where I'm going without risk? Omega in itself is a, well, it's a hypersensitive matter. If it were to become public, I think it would be disastrous. Something you're not, never will. Always a feeling.
Because the movie is all about people of mask, right? So when a baby is born, they straight away put a mask on it. So I'm the guy kind of ordering those guys to, you know, put the mask on the babies.
I've known Mark for about a year, and he pulled me in instantly. Him and his creative little projects intrigued me, and we've been sharing writing ideas. And I'm constantly bringing him supplies. I work as a grip in the film industry, and he's in need of anything that he can get way of doom team, bounce board, 2x4 plywood. So I'm constantly bringing him stuff, letting him know when shows are down, and I fill a truck and bring it over. For today, I guess I ended up being the AD, the assistant director, and then got roped into wardrobe because our wardrobe woman is working this evening. Craft service. I'm hosting the wrap party. It's been a lot of fun. I really enjoyed working with him and all the people that he's included in this project.
I'm mom, but I'm younger than my daughter. Hi. So.
Nutrient.
Cluster has been reduced to 4 members.
So, you know, we look nothing alike, and I'm younger than she is. So it's just really entertaining, because I don't know when I had her. Like, in the womb, I had a child. That's it. That's just, you know.
Run out of the door. Okay, Jenny,
help us do this.
Brady, what?
Mark.
Exactly right there.
Okay.
Got it?
Great. I think his movies can go far. I'm sure he'll get a job from it, because it definitely shows that he can go to anything out of nothing.
pretty cool.
Satellite. Klingons have never been trustworthy.
The MTV satellite.
Forced to agree with Admiral Kirk.
Spreading rock and roll.
Terrifying.
The universe.
It is imperative that we act now to support the global initiative.
Styrofoam ball, take some spray paint, a couple different colors. You know,
just
do sort of a
planet.
Yeah.
Yeah. Then it kind of gives it away.
But you don't want to show the planet.
It's so low tech that
right.
If you show a planet, then your mom.
Less is more in this case.
Less is more in this case.
All right. Just east of Highland in Hollywood, California. And this is the definition of independent filmmaking.
People.
Oh, they're
in Hollywood. You know, Mark really accepts us for who we are. Really, you know, he really feels that we're really people, not like other movies who just don't even give you a chance if you have a mask or a face. It's really, really refreshing.
The first thing when I. The first time I saw Mark, when he invited me over, he told me about the movie. Somehow I thought it was crazy, because you know, it was like the backyard, and he made this factory and stuff. I thought he was playing, but anyway, now I can say he's one amazing guy, very innovative, and I mean, it's unbelievable what he can do out of just few stops, getting this stuff.
Look. Perfect.
He can make anything out of anything. Yeah, I think he will do great things in the future, that I know.
I'm multi-talented.
As you know,
I don't just speak, you know.
I'm not just a voice actress.
That's right. I'm much more. You get the full package here. With Susan Warner Simpson, you can be sure that you're getting a quality piece of merchandise or your money back. Oh, wait a minute. You're not paying me.
Okay. Let's just start putting it down.
Get
it? I'm all set.
I am.
Name?
My name's Sean, and I met Mark because he's actually our mechanic who helps us take care of our Barracuda, which is a 1966 old car, and through meeting him and that, started noticing all these very bizarre things in his driveway that he was always working on. And, dogs. Way that he'd be working on, and more and more as we became friends, he asked us if we'd be extras in certain scenes, and that's how I got involved in working with him.
Two, take one.
All you gotta do is plug it in.
Make sure the switches are off.
If the switches are off.
So maybe the plastic bag, the plastic cup with the top cut off.
Go.
It's been funny. There have been a lot of jinxed moments, I guess you could say.
Yeah. Any stories you want to share? Hold on, let's wait for the helicopter to go by.
You know, I mean, when I started doing this project, I never knew how, you know, what kind of scale it would go to. I didn't even know it was going to be a feature-length film. Honestly, when I started this, you know, it was just like a small little project that he asked me to be a part of, and I said, yeah, sure. You know, thought it would be a two-month type thing, and thought it would be a good experience, just fun, different, and definitely has been fun, different, and an experience. But as far as where I hope this film will go, you know, from the beginning I never thought that it would even be festival type, you know. I didn't know, so that's great. If I knew that, maybe I'd have put more into it from the beginning.
Never too late.
That's right. We still have
two. Desert.
We have two shots left.
All right. I had a question, but I forgot.
Conspiracy theorists of the world unite.
Here's your answer. See, I'm using my hand to make like a little bucket to hold the powder, and this is called Pyrodex. We're using FFFG gauge, which is also known as P. In Pyrodex. It's the finest available ground powder that you can get, which makes it burn faster. So we're going to use that. Just common Estes model rocket igniters can be ignited on as little as I think 6 volts. So since we're using 12 volts, we're not having any problems igniting these. And I like to solder everything, so that's how I'm doing this.
No, Mark, I thought he was a clown. It was a class with him and a really, really interesting acting class, I must say. Definitely was an experience. And I didn't really know what I was getting myself into. I was like, okay, I'd like to do something here, a little film thing. And at first it wasn't about, like, I wasn't even going to be a big lead character. It was just the boyfriend. And then, I don't know what happened, but suddenly I became the instigator. Even though I'm kind of a reactive force, and she's more like a force of nature. And, like, I feel like I suddenly became like the storyline. I'm like the carrier of the story. So that whole thing took me by surprise, and it became an experience. Like I started getting involved in the film. Like.
What now?
Funny, you know, what it was about, because it really didn't seem to have a story at all at first. Like, he wasn't really giving out anything. It was just kind of falling together as things came along. And then the next thing we knew, we had a complete story, and we came up with, like, all these subplots that exist, and we were like, I wonder if anyone will ever catch it. If anyone will ever really see what we're trying to say. And then it became like a story to tell more than just a movie.
Stays like this.
Stays like this.
When I'm glad, I'm not a guy with a mask on. I haven't acted in any of this, and I am the most thankful person for that. But it's been an adventure.
Everybody in the frame?
This is just villagers.
Just villagers, yeah.
How far can we go before we're out of the frame?
You're out when you're out like this. From the pipe sail to that fence line right there. Okay, walk. On the news about 2 weeks ago, running on the freeway. You're running nude on the freeway.
No.
That was the freest guy in society ever. Can you imagine being nude, running down the freeway, running after the cars? You'd be the freest individual on the planet Earth. He's in jail for a couple of years, but... Okay, that's what she's doing. So you gotta go get her, because she's breaking the law. The government regulated law. And when you do, you just walk up to her like a zombie and you're gonna just get her. Hey.
Automatic defense procedures initiated.
I am now undeniably the man with the chosen gun.
It's the biggest part of the show.
He's got a lead.
Cool, man.
A big play.
Cool.
He's going up.
Hey, you got any leads?
Leads?
Yeah.
This lead is the lead I actually have on my resume.
I know, that's what I was trying to tell. Someone's like, would you ever use Viagra? I'm like, no, actually, I need the opposite of Viagra because I can't get it soft.
You need Diagra.
Diagra. You need Diagra.
Exactly.
That's exactly what I need, too. Give me a bottle, off. Will ya?
And I was in a show.
We call it paper mache is Diagra.
Diagra.
Anti-beat.
No, it's called libido off.
My libido off?
I need my libido off, actually. My libido needs to turn off. I need libido off. Okay, well, let's beat off to the top of the mountain.
Say, look into the camera, speak loud, and just say, I'm here for the beer.
I'm here for the beer.
I came here because I live across the street, and they told me that there was going to be beer here, and to wear some coveralls and be a movie star.
Go on and on.
Yeah, we're hoping that this will eventually go to a film festival, hopefully Sundance, but we'll see. And I think Mark is a very talented director and filmmaker, and we're really hoping that this will turn into something big for all of us eventually.
Conspiracy theorists of the world unite. Chance you're right.
Hey guys.
Hey.
How'd that go?
Went pretty good. Still on fire.
I'm blowing it up real good.
Let's go to the storage unit.
Yeah. Do you think this movie's ever gonna be finished?
I sure hope so.
What do you think the future's gonna bring to this movie?
Well, I think for Mark, it's gonna show the people how he made this film out of basically nothing. I mean, this film's made pretty much out of LA alleys and no budget, and he's pretty much done it all himself with the help of his friends. So I think they're gonna be able to take a look at it and say, wow, this is a guy who made a whole sci-fi independent film out of nothing. And I mean, that's valuable.
Lord knows your mother, she sleeps yet. Lord knows your mother, your mother who suckled you with her breath.